I don't know about you, but the fact that I woke up this morning and said to myself that Cloud is in Smash is still shocking the shit out of me. A sentence that I never, ever thought I would say. But it happened. 2 days ago, Daddy Sakurai rocked our worlds. Now, of course, I know a lot of you guys are saying this was definitely one of the most important announcements in Smash history, but you're wrong. It's not just one of the most important announcements, it is the most important, monumental, significant action ever done in Smash Brothers history, the whole game series history, rather. And I know while a lot of you agree with me on that statement, there are going to be some naysayers who say opposite, who don't really understand how important this is. So for you guys, this is top five, or at least my opinion, top five reasons as to why Cloud Strife's inclusion in Smash Brothers is the most monumental event in the game's history. There's a lot of doozies in here, so let's get straight into it. Somehow, some way, this announcement did not leak. Now, if we looked at the trailer for Cloud, we would see that everything about him is pretty much complete. All of his animations are done, he has all of his special moves, even his stage is totally complete, with the transitions being done, even the background entities, the summon spirits, the, you know, Ifrit, Bahamut, all of those dudes are in there. And even though all of this completion is done for him, still, we don't have a release date, but whatever, that doesn't really matter at this point, because the argument is that how much time do you think Cloud has to have been in development for him to be totally finished now? Daddy Sakurai told us that the process of creating a character in Smash Brothers could potentially be a really difficult one. So I'm guessing that with everything that Cloud has going on for him, including the stage and all the moves he has, and you know, he even has his limit break in the game, and his Final Smash, of course, he must have been in development for a year. Or, you know, at least a year, maybe a year and a half to 2 years potentially, because let's not forget that Nintendo would also have to make negotiations happen with other companies to be able to do something like this. So if we say from the very beginning, then maybe 2 years. Now let's look at everything that leaked in that 2 year time span. The entire roster of Smash 4 was leaked on 4chan in the summer of 2014. Roy and Ryu were found in the game's data during the Mewtwo update that happened earlier this year. So a lot of surprises were killed for us in a lot of ways, and those are just two of the major ones. There are a lot of smaller ones that have happened over time too. Yet somehow, Cloud being in development throughout that entire span of time did not get leaked. No word about Cloud ever, to the point where everyone thought that it was basically impossible. The fact that Daddy Sakurai somehow managed to keep this under wraps is one of the most mind-boggling things I've ever heard, and I have to give him props on so many levels for managing to keep this a secret. It makes you wonder, how did the work process go for him? Maybe Daddy Sakurai was the only person working the Cloud project because he knew for a fact that, you know, too many people involved and things start to go out. I wouldn't be surprised if he was the only one that was working on Cloud. You know, like my man Shofu said, this dude must have seriously had Will Smith from Men in Black come through to that office, and if there was anybody that was working with him, he wiped their memory as soon as they were done for the day, man. And while on the subject of Daddy Sakurai, let's take into consideration that there were so many people, like I said earlier, who thought something like this would be totally impossible. Everybody thought that there would be some kind of red tape preventing Nintendo from bringing over any Final Fantasy characters to Smash Brothers. This is something that always blew my mind though, because how do you know what the relations of certain companies are? You're not in their offices, and you're not with them at their meetings. Even though you may see things on the surface, it doesn't mean that these companies don't have a rapport going on. I mean, the same could be said for Ubisoft and Nintendo, or Ubisoft, as some people want to say it like that. People thought that they would never work together, and yet, there is a Rayman trophy in Smash Brothers, and, you know, of course they had bad relations in the past over some things, but those shouldn't be enough for people to be able to feel like they know what's gonna happen, or they can predict what's gonna happen. They see things that Sakurai did in the past, they make up these patterns that happen, and then they say to themselves, okay, I know for a fact Sakurai will never do this or that, and he will do that or that. You don't know. No one knows, and he proved this to us 2 days ago. This announcement was the equivalent of Daddy Sakurai saying to us, this is my game, you have no idea what I'm gonna do, and I'm gonna do what the hell I wanna do. You're just strapped into my wild ride, and that's all that you need to know. Guys, this announcement is so big, and this is why I think it's even bigger than the Smash ballot, because there were so many people that figured, hey, this character on the Smash ballot won't be able to make it in the game because look at this red tape in this area that I think exists, which actually doesn't exist. I mean, you know how many people were telling me that Banjo-Kazooie can't be in Smash Brothers due to, you know, Microsoft litigation and details keeping him from being put in Nintendo games? But the announcement 2 days ago showed us that any fictional red tape that you have in your head, it's not actually there. These moves can be definitely made. You know, Sakurai's a special man. Let's not forget that either. So, yeah. Anybody that thought that they knew what this man is capable of, you don't know shit. And I'm glad that this announcement happened because now that'll reassure you all that you don't know shit. And you won't just go ahead and make your assumptions based on previous activity that Sakurai has done because he can do whatever the hell he wants and he definitely will. And he definitely has. Holy shit. Going into reason number 3, right now is a very hype time for the Nintendo NX because it's being talked about all over the place. There are dev kits that are going out there and a lot of rumors are being made from those. Nintendo has hyped this thing up so much without revealing a single detail as to what the hell we are looking at here. The NX could potentially be getting Final Fantasy games, main series games, on it in the future. Nintendo and Final Fantasy, you know, Square Enix, they have worked together in the past. They've had a lot of titles for their mobile platforms, and you know, Crystal Chronicles is a great series as well too, but they, you know, Final Fantasy never really had a main flagship game on a Nintendo console in a long time. But the NX might just be the dawn of a new age where Final Fantasy main series games will be put on the NX. I gotta give big props to my man Obi-Wan, who actually gave me the extra idea on this, the fact that we could potentially be seeing Final Fantasy 15 ported to the NX. And if the NX is as strong as some of the rumors are saying, then this is definitely something technically possible. Of course, a lot of you will might say, oh, it's impossible for them to have a Final Fantasy game, a main flagship game on the NX. But I mean, you were saying the same thing about Cloud Strife being in Smash Brothers before. And now we were shown that that is not a barrier that can't be broken. So who's to say that we don't get a main flagship Final Fantasy in the future on the NX? Considering that Nintendo is doing their best to rebuild their third-party support with everyone, I can see this as a big possibility, and I don't think that it should be moved off the table just due to you thinking that one thing is possible or not, based on how companies interact on the surface, when in reality you don't really know what they're doing behind closed doors. Our second reason has everything to do with Cloud, but not him as a person, but rather what he represents. Some of you dudes may be a little too young to remember all the details, but I'll fill you in. Final Fantasy VII was released on the PlayStation 1 a while ago, and its release on the PS1 dawned a new age of Square Enix and Sony being bed buddies and making a whole lot of sweet deals underneath the sheets. All their main series games would be on Sony platforms for the future. Final Fantasy also would be totally removed from Nintendo. Now, like I said, there were games after the fact, you know, after a while that did get released on Nintendo handhelds and even their GameCube and other consoles too, but their main games would never be on a Nintendo console again. Cloud represents a sour relationship and a really sour end as to what happened to Nintendo and Square Enix way back in the day. Also represents the fact that JRPGs became massive after Final Fantasy VII. And, you know, they were always popular to an extent, but Final Fantasy VII changed the game and brought about new standards and new approaches to JRPGs and is widely considered one of the best ones out there, and not just JRPG, but one of the best games ever created as well. The fact that he's now actually in Smash Brothers means that those bridges have been rebuilt, the feelings are pushed aside, and now the main goal is to just get people hype. And now, the number one reason as to why this is the most important announcement for Smash Brothers ever also coincides with another upcoming Final Fantasy game, and not 15. You know what I'm talking about, man. The 7 Remake. This remake has been desired, craved, and demanded by fans for over a decade. You know, almost 2 decades, rather. There were a lot of times where developers of it said, oh, you know, it's not possible for us to port it. It'll be too much work. The game is, you know, it's a legacy game as it is. We don't want to touch it. But Final Fantasy, Square Enix finally broke down, and they are releasing the game as a remake for future 2017 release date, I think. I don't know if it's set in stone, but I don't think it's going to hit 2017 either. Maybe 2020 or something, considering Square Enix's track record. We still have confirmation that it's being worked on. And we saw like little trailers and teasers in the past of them remaking scenes in Final Fantasy VII just to show off Sony hardware. And it used to play with everyone's balls. But now we actually do have confirmation for it. So think about how amazing it would be to have a whole new audience of fresh blood brought over from the Nintendo side of things now that Cloud is actually inside of Smash Brothers. You know, this is the amazing thing about the game. It cross-collaborates with other fandoms to create an even bigger one. When Smash Brothers included Shulk, a lot of people didn't know who he was or where he was from, but after his inclusion, so many people are way more aware of the Xenoblade franchise, and it's basically blown up ever since, with huge popularity spikes and a lot of people anxious for the new game coming out with Xenoblade Chronicles X. It already came out in Japan, but it's coming out for other regions as well. And this is the same thing that's going to happen in the future with Final Fantasy VII's remake and Cloud being in Smash Brothers. The people from the Final Fantasy side of things are actually going to be moving over to Smash Brothers to try it out since they see that there's actually their favorite character on the platform, while at the same time, the Nintendo guys are going to go to check out the remake in the future to see what it's all about after witnessing the amazingness of Cloud in Smash. This is the biggest reason, because Smash Brothers is one of the biggest games ever created, and at the same time, Final Fantasy VII is also deserving of that title. They came together. Holy fucking nigger. I gotta stop fucking saying that. Holy shit. But anyways, guys, thank you for joining me on this little, you know, this small, little, short, little video about the top five reasons as to why this is the biggest announcement in Smash history, and even going a step further, one of the biggest announcements for gaming, period. There's not many things that can live up to the amazingness of Cloud in Smash, but it happened. If you can show me anything that tops that, I'll be blown away. But anyways, guys, I will talk to you all in the next video. Take care of yourselves, and of course, as usual, please have yourself a damn good one.